everyone, I'm Suraya and I'm a PhD student at the University of Liverpool under the guidance of Dr. Janine Kavanagh. In today's day and age, we have a lot of technology to help us understand the processes that happen on the surface of the Earth. However, we don't have a similar amount of understanding of what goes on beneath the surface and how the two relate. So today I'm going to talk to you about analog modeling and how we can tie these two things together. So this study aims to answer these questions with focus on dike propagation in an elastic material. So first of all, subsurface deformation, what does that look like? Secondly, what are the geometries involved in the growth of dikes? Thirdly, how is deformation expressed on the surface during dike propagation? And does subsurface deformation and the shapes of these dikes influence the final pattern? How am I going to do this? I will be using gelatin as the crustal analog, and I will be using dike water as the magma analog. So dike water is going to be injected directly into the base of this perspex tank at a constant flux. And because we have three things that we're focusing on, we have three key observation tools. So firstly, to look at the internal stresses, we have one camera looking into a set of polarizing films. Secondly, to look at the geometry, how it's shaped and how fast it grows, we have a second camera looking in this direction. And lastly, to look at the surface deformation, we have an overhead laser scanner that's partnered with a software called Scan Control. So what do we get from this experimental setup? So if we see here, this is a set of three photographs taken at three different time steps. And we see through the polarizing film that there are bowtie shaped stress fields. So it starts off really small and localized right on the tips of the dikes before growing wider in extent prior to eruption. What does it look like on the other side? Well, through camera two, we can see that it starts off nice and circular, equal in height and width, and it looks kind of like a penny shape. And this penny shape continues to grow halfway through the experiment, and right prior to eruption, it shoots up and forms an ellipsoid. So this is done quantitatively, just based on video, but if you put this into analysis numerically, we can see that it does agree with this trend of having a penny shape to start with and ending it with an ellipse where it is taller than it is wider. Next, we will have a look at the velocities of the dike, and we see that it has three very obvious stages of growth. So it starts off with a stage of deceleration, which allows the dike to grow into this penny shape. Then we have a stage of constant growth, where this dike grows equally in shape all around, keeping that penny-like shape still. And towards the end, right before eruption, it accelerates and pulls itself up and makes this nice ellipsoid shape. Lastly, results from the laser scanner show that in the last 120 seconds, the dike produces this pattern here on the surface. So we see here that we have two topographic highs flanking a region of topographic low. And if we plot where the dike tips were at each profile, we can see that this agrees well to what we find here, where it does an acceleration prior to eruption. So we can see collectively that these results do help us to understand the relationship between surface deformation and subsurface deformation. And as a whole, this will help us further to constrain when and where an eruption may happen in the future. Thank you.